Hello friends, let's talk about today's video. So in this video I will be talking about your writing task 1, that is writing an email. So sometimes you get an email that is called the apology email, and you are making an apology to someone, might be to your manager for something that you haven't done, might be you have done something wrong because of that. So I'm going to talk about the templates or the format for that particular topic, how you can frame your introduction and conclusion, and how you can extend the reasons. But before that, I would request you to subscribe the channel. If you have not subscribed it, do it now and press the bell icon. Okay, so now have a look towards the question first. So this is the question. So the topic says, you missed an important meeting at work. So you missed an important meeting at work. This suggests that you're supposed to write to someone at your workplace, write an email to your manager. And whenever you write an email to your manager means this is a semi-formal kind of email. In your email, you need to include the very first, apologize for not attending. So you have to give the reasons, you have to say sorry basically, okay, that why you were not able to do it. Explain why you didn't attend. You need to explain the reason here. And third paragraph, say what you will do to make up for it. So now you have to speak something that how you will be managing with the thing, something that you missed. Okay, fine. So now we'll talk about it. Like once you have this topic, you have given like three different questions. Apologize, give the reasons, and how you are going to make it up, or basically a solution. So we'll start with like this. Dear Mr. Smith, since you are writing to your manager, you can say dear manager, or if you know the name, you can better say dear Mr. Smith. Then it's always a good idea to give a brief introduction once you are writing formal email or semi-formal. So we'll start like, my name is Harry and I'm writing to apologize. So what is the purpose of writing? The purpose is apologizing. So straight away the question says apologize. So make sure the purpose of writing this email must be clear in the opening of this response. So this is what we have done here. I'm writing to apologize for not being able to attend the meeting, or whatever the purpose that you should write here. I know my presence was important, however I couldn't make it. Okay, so this is how you can explain the introduction. Then at the same time, it worked for the apology. You need not to make a separate paragraph for apology. Writing sorry again and again seems to be quite embarrassing for the readers as well. Now second paragraph, you can talk about the reason I wasn't there is that. So you can explain the reason here and make sure as per the requirement of the topic, the reason should be unavoidable and sudden. It should not be, I already told you this is happening and all, right? So you cannot talk about a pre-planned event. You couldn't say that it was my birthday, so obviously I was celebrating. So these kind of excuses are not welcomed in corporate sector or in your workplace. So give a certain reason. Might be you got stuck in some official meeting, might be it was a family emergency, and in fact you got so much indulged, so much tensed because of that emergency, you were not able to inform your manager because of that. Then I know I should be responsible for my act, however the situation left me helpless. So this is how when you write like this, the other person have a little sympathy for you, and you'll be forgiven also. Okay, so however the situation left me helpless, I never meant to disappoint you. It means whatever I have done or whatever has happened, basically that was unintentional. Then the conclusion, the last sentence or the concluding sentence, I trust you would accept my sincere apologies. So whenever you are writing for the formal and semi-formal, you better write like this. You would accept my sincere apologies. And trust is a better word than hope. So we always prefer to write trust here. Then the sign off is kind regards. You can write kind regards. You can write yours truly or yours sincerely. Then your name in that. So make sure the name that you have given in the beginning and name at the end must remain same. You cannot change it sometime. Might be due to absence of mind. Okay. So I hope this topic is clear to you. And these structured sentences will help you to define or to design your email in real exam beautifully. So keep learning with me. All the best.